Welcome. It is quite common that you pre-calculate GI maps before rendering an animation with vray to avoid any flickering and to save some rendering time too. RebusFarm fully supports this workflow, and in this tutorial, we will show you the steps you should follow if you want to render an animation with this workflow using 3ds Max and vray. We are using here Max 2019 and vray next, but the same process should be applicable with other versions too. Let's open Render Setup and check the GI tab. I'm using here a radiance map as the primary engine and light cache as secondary engine. We will use pre-calculated maps, but if you would like to see how to calculate those locally, let us know in the comments, and we can do a separate tutorial for that. Go to a radiance map rollout and make sure the current mode is set to From File. Now press the three little dots to choose the pre-calculated irradiance map file, then press Open. We will do the same for light cache. Change the mode from Fly Through to From File and browse to the directory of Save Light Cache Map. Under the vray tab, global switches make sure to disable Don't Render Final Image too, as you might have used it for GI calculation earlier. Under the Common tab, make sure to specify the range frame that you need to render. In this case, it is from 0 to 50. Also, it is common that when you calculate the irradiance map, you change every nth frame parameter to something other than 1 to save time, so make sure to set it back to 1 for the final render. Go to Render Output and press Files. Type the name for the shot and choose the render format that you like. In our case, we will use TIF. Press Save, then OK. Now we are ready to submit the job. Please refer to our previous videos for more info about submitting using 3ds Max. In this case, I will just submit with the default settings. RebusDrop will upload all the assets, including the previously loaded GI maps. When the upload is complete, the rendering will start, and you can check the preview for the rendered frame to avoid any issues, so you can pause or stop the rendering. Also note that, as soon as one frame is done, the download process will start automatically to save time. You can press Open Download Folder to check the rendered frames. The rendering process is complete now, and here is all the rendered frames that we did. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, please consider giving us a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please let us know in the comment section. Here are also some other videos that might interest you. To keep up to date with our channel, don't forget to subscribe.